Hi, my name is Weipeng, and I'm here to talk to you about our work on using deep neural networks for the joint detection and localization of speakers for robots. Our work emphasizes the application in real HI scenarios, where there are multiple overlapping sound sources, the number of which is unknown. There is robot ego noise, and the predictions should be made from short inputs so that the predictions are real-time, as well as that it is possible to detect short utterances. So, how does our neural network work for such problem? We consider two types of input features for the network. The first feature is the center coefficient of the GCC fat function computed for each pair of microphones. And the other type is the GCC fat on mile scale filter bank.
Since different sources in general dominate different time frequency bins, this feature provides the subband information that allows easier detection of multiple sources.
For the network output, we propose a likelihood-based coding. That is, the network outputs the likelihood value of a source bin from each individual direction.
During training, the ideal output is the maximum of Gaussian-like functions around the ground truth directions of arrival.
And during application, as like spatial spectrums, we decode the output by finding the peaks as the predictions. Such output coding allows the detection of an arbitrary number of sources. As for the network architecture, we investigate three different types, including a multi-layer perception with the GCC fat coefficients as input, a convolutional neural network which treats the GCC fat on filter bank as images, and a two-stage network which considers the subband analysis before aggregation across all frequencies. To train and evaluate the proposed methods, we collected a sound source localization dataset with our robot Pepper. The dataset includes in total 24 hours recordings of both loudspeakers and human subjects. We made the dataset available through this link. It can serve as a benchmark dataset for further studies. Our proposed method achieved approximately 90% precision and recall in both the loudspeaker and the human subject recordings, outperforming the popular spatial spectrum-based methods. We will show you some results at the end of the video, and thank you for watching.
We have also implemented two buttons for increase
to send messages, of course, to the TV. It should have 9 channel buttons, a next button, volume buttons, subtitle buttons, switch to control features, color, contrast, sharpness, etc.
0 to 1 to 0 if buttons are a button for
company
a teletext,
for
subtitles,
company label,
and the company logo.
I would like to check the weather.
What languages do you use?
I would like to
speak
the weather.
Do you know where is the supermarket? I'd like to buy a camera. Can you speak Chinese?
Do you like pancakes?
What languages do you speak?
Chocolate.